Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This is Declaration of Faith, number 18. Topic is Child, Servant, Son, and Bride all have rewards in heaven. Where will you be in heaven? God ordains His servants to do His ministry with Holy Ghost baptism and with gifts. God's servants will also serve in the temple of God in paradise, which is a new earth. Born again is different from baptism of the Holy Ghost. It is a continuous process, and it contains born of the Spirit, born of water, born of God. It begins with born of the Spirit. It is by receiving the Holy Spirit from God and grow in the Spirit. It is like a spiritual baby is born and grew. The second step is to be born of water. The Word of God is compared to water, and that which cleans the dirt. The water cleans the dirt, and in this case, the Word of God cleans the sin. So the water is compared to the Word of God. So born of water is born of Word, born of the Word. If God opens up our understanding of His Word, that we are born of water, because the understanding to take the Word of God into us is given to us. The Holy Spirit is given to us. We are born of the Spirit. When the understanding of the Word is given to us, it is born of the water. And the Word, by doing the Word we study and doing what God says in the Word, that is our growth. If we are fully grown in the Word, then we are sons of God. The third step is to go for the higher calling of God. It is to be born of God. And the growth is to become perfect as Jesus Christ is perfect in this category. They are called the bride of the Lamb, or the bride of Christ. Children will attain a new earth. It is paradise. Sons will be at new heavens. It is plural. The bride will be with Jesus Christ in Mount Sion. We all will receive rewards from God according to our works, according to what we do. Unrighteous people, those do evil, will be cast into hell and then into the lake of fire. Righteous people will inherit heaven according to their level, according to their works, what they do. Now let us study the four steps or the four levels in heaven. God ordains His servants for His ministry here in this world. Jesus Christ told His disciples in Acts chapter 1. I'm going to read that. Verse 4. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart. This is Jesus Christ telling His disciples. They should not depart Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which said He, you have heard of Me. That means He told that even before. Now He's reminding them. I'm telling you again. So you should not depart Jerusalem until you receive the promise of the Father. Verse 5, for John truly baptizes with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. So that is, he's saying, as John baptized, this will be baptism of the Holy Ghost. So no, it won't take too many days. You'll get it soon. Then verse 6 and 7, it's not in the subject, it's a kind of distortion. And verse 8, but you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto Me both in Jerusalem and in Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. Oh, that's the mission. Then he says, verse 9, Well, not when he says, what happened in verse 9. And when he has spoken these things, while they beheld, while they are looking at him, he was taken up in the cloud and received him out of their sight. The cloud came and received him out of the sight. So that is a fantastic scene they were seeing. And just before, so this is a grand finale of his ascension, he gave the commandment to his disciples to wait for the baptism of the Holy Ghost before they start the ministry. He gave the ministry to them, then said, wait until you receive the baptism and power from heaven. This is very important for the ministry. Without power, we cannot do anything. Without the Holy Ghost baptism, we cannot do anything. But still, people go to the seminaries and learn something from the books, and they ordain some to become ministers. But that's not the pattern of God. God have this way and not the seminary way. So the disciples and about 120 people waited and received the baptism of the Holy Ghost and the power of God. The baptism of the Holy Ghost is the ordination. Jesus Christ ordains his people, his disciples, for his ministry. If that ordination, we don't receive it, then we don't have ordination. We are practicing the ministry without the license from God. The Holy Ghost also gives them gifts. Those who have done good service to the Lord in the ministry, if you do good, honest, sincere service to God here, when we are on the earth, in the ministry here, we also serve God in heaven, because in heaven, the temple of God is opened in paradise. It's new earth. And Revelation chapter 21, verse 3 says, and I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with man, referring to new earth. The temple of God is open in new earth, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself be with them and be their God. The tabernacle of God is in new earth. I said his servants will serve them there. But the thing is, one thing different. In new heavens, the presence of God is there. There'll be, there's no temple in the new heavens. New earth, there's a temple. But God reveals them, God shows them, the presence of God is there. In a way, like God was present in the Old Testament in the tabernacles, and when God comes in, the cloud fills the temple, the presence of God was there. Nobody else could enter. That's the kind of thing. Not the very presence of God directly. So that there's a difference. God's presence in the temple or in the new heavens, Jesus Christ was present to them as he is. We will see as he is in new heavens, but new earth, his presence is there. Born of the Spirit, this is the servants of God, which the baptism of the Holy Spirit, born of God or born again, that is, born of the Spirit, those are different. And the Holy Spirit, and the other one is Holy Ghost baptism. Born of the Spirit is to receive the Holy Spirit in us. That is what born of the Spirit. We're born, when you're born of the flesh, we receive, our soul receive our flesh body. And here, when we're born of the Spirit, our soul receives the Spirit body. So that's why born of the Spirit. And the baptism of the Holy Ghost is different from this. Born of the Spirit is to receive the Holy Spirit, and in order to live a righteous life, the Holy Spirit will be in us and inducing us, directing us, guiding our path towards the righteous life. This controls the life. The baptism of the Holy Ghost directs the ministry. So those are two differences. It is important to know. And Jesus Christ says in John chapter 3, we know the scriptures, everybody knows it, but still, John chapter 3, verse from 3, 3 and 6, John chapter 3, verse 3. Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. And verse 6 says, two verse down, that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the spirit is spirit. The same way we're born of the flesh, now this time we're born of the spirit. So flesh, born of the flesh, we are, and born of the spirit, we cannot see with the visual eye, but it is as real as born of the flesh. Until a person is born of the spirit, he cannot see the kingdom. We just said that. Until he's born of the born again, we cannot see the kingdom. When the Holy Spirit is first born into a person, he or she became a child of God, a spiritual infant. The baby must grow. When Jesus was a man, he was filled with the Spirit beyond measure. This is the same chapter, John 3, 34. For he whom God has sent, God has given the Spirit by, he whom God has sent, speak of the words of God, for God giveth not the Spirit by measure unto him. That means he gives the Spirit beyond measure, without measure. So the Holy Spirit is given by measure, not by the count. God the Spirit, God the Spirit, and that's it. So it's not that way. Even if you have the Spirit, then again, you have more, and you can receive more, That is the way the Holy Spirit works. Baptism of the Holy Ghost is one time. It's baptized you, that's give the gifts, and so that's here. It's not that way. It is by measure. When you receive the Spirit, and if you could not overcome certain sins, cry out to God, he give more power, more Spirit. So this is by measure. That's also important to know. And John 7, the same book, John 7, verse 37 to 39. In the last days, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, If any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. The drink here, we're talking about the Holy Spirit, that will come later. Let me come to me and drink, verse 38. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of water. If you drink, then the rivers of water will come out of you. That's it will multiply. That's what it says. 39, but this speak he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not given because of the Jesus was not a glory. So it will be given to them. The Holy Ghost is God. He gives the Spirit. He's one of the gifts of the Spirit. This is the Holy Spirit he gives to them. So when that comes in, so he's talking about, if he said drink water, should not think otherwise. It says about the Holy Spirit. He says drink, but drink the Spirit into him. And it will be, if you drink, then the rivers of water may come, or just we can take a sip. God wish that you drink full and grow to the maximum. That's the desire of God. But what we do is we may drink the Holy Spirit according to our thirst. If we are very thirsty, we drink a lot of water. If you're just a little thirsty, some of us may be satisfied as soon as our tongue gets wet. Just a little sip, and that's good enough. And that way, so if we take just a little bit and if we stay in that level, we may reach new earth, because our holy life will not be intensive. We are reach the lower level of heaven. When you say heaven, don't ever think just heaven is heaven, that's one flat deal. It's not that. According to what you have done, If you've done little, that's new earth. If you little more, if you sacrifice yourself as a martyr, those kind of things, if you dedicate your whole life for that, that you'll be the bride or sons of God. So in heaven, there's a lot of different things. We have to study from the scripture. It is interesting to study. So if you take a little bit of the spirit and you're satisfied with that, there's nothing wrong with that. That's what we wanted. If that's all the thirst you have, you go to new earth. But don't be jealous of those who go to the higher grade, higher level. A few others will keep on drinking until their bellies are full and overflowing. He says, until from them the rivers of water will come from them. So they may reach new heavens and in Mount Sion with Jesus. They will be with Jesus, not the presence like the new earth, but direct him, presence of him, other person. And God will give us according to our works. If you work for more, we get more. Otherwise, we get whatever. As long as we get to heaven, we'll be happy. But born of water is born of the Word. We just touched it before. Born of the water is it's the Word. John 3:5, we saw that. Jesus says, "Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God." First he said, born again, and you cannot see, born of the Spirit, you cannot see the kingdom. Now he said, born of water and the Spirit. The Spirit, then we born of water. To enter. So in order to enter, you have another qualification. So in addition of being born of the Spirit, a person must be born of water also to enter his kingdom. How is the person be born of water? This is symbolic language. We saw that before. In Ephesians chapter 5, verse 26, says Ephesians. Let's go to Ephesians chapter 5. Ephesians chapter 5, verses 26. That he might sanctify, he's talking about the water, that's what the scripture I take it, water, what to explain what the water is, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of the water. This is by the water he's going to cleanse, but it's not actually the water, it's washing of the water by the Word. So the Word is said with the name water, because as the water cleans the dirt from our body, the Word of God cleanses from sin. That's what the thing is. That he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy without blemish. So the dirt here with the Word cleanses is the sin to make it pure, cleansed, to be sanctified. That is why he compared that with the water, but actually it is the Word of God. So the purification is done as we obey God. If you read the Word, you don't do a thing. A lot of people ceremonially read from Genesis to Revelation, maybe 100 times you can read it and you will have no change in you. It's not that. You read the 10 verses, you obey the 10 verses. It's a lot better than reading the whole Bible from the beginning to the end and don't change at all. So it's not the reading of the Word, ceremonially or otherwise, or memorizing, doesn't matter. That's the doing, you obeying, obey the Word. That's what it matters. The First Peter, First Peter verse 1 or 23 says, born again, not of the corruptible seed, but the incorruptible, by the Word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. So there, the Word of God is not only washing, it abides, it lives in the person, which liveth and abide in us. That's what Peter says. That is, the Word of God should be in us, a part of us. Not only we will do what, oh, God says to do this, let me do this. It's not that. the Word of God is a part of you. You are the Word of God. That means you are, you'd be instinctively doing it as from your brain. So Word of God became your brain, so it'll be instinctively doing the righteous, holy things of God. That's what it says. The Word of God abides in you. It's not memorizing. You know, so the people sometimes say memorizing the Word. Yeah, memorizing is good. I'm not against those kind of things. But just those kind of things won't cut it. So you have to live the life. In 1 John chapter 2, let's go to 1 John chapter 2. First John chapter chapter 2 verse the first the word 14 verse 14 the first John chapter 2 verse 14 I have written to you fathers because you have known him from the beginning, and I have written to you young men because and the Word of God abideth in you, and you have overcome the wicked one. So if the Word of God abide in you, you will overcome the wicked one. Wicked one is the devil, or demons, or evil, or any kind of activities, any kind of manifestation of the devil. You will overcome. Naturally you will overcome, because the Word of God is in you. You will overcome the devil. And so that is a barn of water. If you come to that level, and you will qualify to enter into the kingdom of God, not the new earth, but as a kingdom God, as the sons of God. And in the resurrection, the sons of God will appear as Jesus Christ is in his glory. There's also the 1 John chapter 3 verse 2, beloved, now you are the sons of God, and it does not appear what we shall be. We can become the bride. That's what it means. We can even go a step higher than the Son of God, but we do not know that yet. And but we shall, when we shall appear, we shall be like him. Like him, Jesus comes in, when you take it for the rapture, when he takes you with him, you will be like him, for we shall see him as he is. It's not the presence. Yeah, it is the presence. He present there. But we can see him as he is, not as a cloud. See, in the new earth, we'll see him as a cloud, not as a person. Here, we see him as he is, the brighter than the sun. So that is what we see him in his glory. That is the sons of God. We have the privilege to be with him, and we will be like him. See, that's what, I'm not saying it, the Word of God is saying it. We'll be like him, and he is bright, and we'll be in his presence. And we inherit new heavens. And that's, it's not sure how we're going to be in the future, but if we have that one, if we have the bride of Christ, or the higher calling, as our hope, we want it. Not, this is good enough. Some people may be good enough just to get to new earth. Ah, just to get it there, that's good enough. So that's one thing. Here, these people became the sons of God, as in the level, to see Jesus Christ face to face, in that level. And they wanted to strive for more, for the higher calling, which is the bride. And verse 3 says, every man that hath this hope, if we have that hope in him, purifieth himself, excuse me, as even he is pure, as Jesus Christ is pure. So that is the higher calling. So, see, as sons of God, we look like him, but it is too greedy, and it's not greedy for spiritual matters. God wants you to have that. That's why it's not greedy. If we on ourselves, we want to grab it, and then that'll be greedy. It's not greedy, because Jesus said, come up! So when he asks you to come up, then when you try to go up, it's not greedy at all. It's obedience. And so you could get it. Ephesians chapter 4, 11 to 13 I have. Chapter 4. 11. And he gave, this is Jesus, God, he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry. So this is done in the church setup or in the work of his ministry. So apostles' doctrine and teaching that and following, breaking of the bread and whatever, prayers. It is for the edifying of the body. Verse 13, well, notice this. Verse 13, till we all come in the unity of faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God. These people say, oh yeah, we got unity of faith and yeah. But let me go further. Unto the perfect man, unto the measure of the status of the fullness of Christ. As Christ is in purity, as Christ is in holiness, as Christ is in righteousness, as he is, to the level of the fullness, level of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that is bride. So God wants us to come to that. God wants us to get to that level. Let us strive for that. The status, if you come to that status, then in John says, 1 John 3:9, we just got 1 John, we'll just lift it. 1 John 3 again, 1 John 3:9, whosoever is born of God doth not commit sin, for his seed remaineth in him, and he cannot sin because he is born of God. So it is a very high verse, and a lot of people fought me and called me all kind of names when I quote this verse for some other things, because I did not quote for them. I quote for the bride. I quote for the sons of God, not for the new heaven people or the ordinary Christians. If you want to be in that level, that's okay. Don't yell at the people who strive. Don't call them heretics and devils and those kind of things. And we should not have a fight. I'm sorry to say that, but we should not. When you say you got to become perfect and you got to get like Jesus, they get angry. They get real mad and they'll fight you. There's no reason for that. But why? So let me read it again. I just missed the point. We cannot sin because, let me read one more time, born of God does not commit sin, that's true, for his seed remain in him. God's seed remain in that person. Seed means a tree. A tree, you cannot put in us, the whole tree is the miniature form, is the seed. The seed is the tree, in miniature form is the seed. Why he will not sin? And he cannot sin because the seed of the tree, the seed of God, he put inside us, or put in the brain programmed us, like we do what God does. See, that is the thing. When you come to that level, when you say that it's not for normal Christians, they have their level, and it's not to that, but it's still, we wish you all come to that level. Paul also says, whoever is perfect and I go for the high calling, God may reveal that to you. And I wish you also come into that level. So everybody should come. But if you cannot come, count your cost. If you don't have enough determination to venture for this, stay. But don't miss a paradise. Don't go to hell. That's horrible. So please escape hell and at least come to new earth or paradise. And John chapter 14, Gospel of John, the Gospel of John, Jesus Christ says I read through maybe just John chapter 14. John chapter 14 verse 2. Notice this. In my father's house are many mansions. Mansions means dwelling places. It were not so, I would have told you. And I go, then the second one, watch this. I go to prepare a place for you. So already there are mansions. Why are we in another place? But he go to another place to prepare for you. So that's second. Then I said, I go to prepare for you, and I'll come again to receive you unto myself. So he received these people to himself. So we need a place and we need that. So this is the thing. And it's for new earth. Yes, already, paradise is already there. It is there. Now it is removed away from people to see or anything. So that is, the mansions are already there, which refers to the new earth. And I'll prepare a place for you, the new heavens, for the sons of God. For the bride, I will receive you unto myself. You will be with me. In me, or with me, we'll be together. So that's a different kind of relationship. The heaven is provided for all three categories, and it's not prudent to fight over scripture and the independent. So it is good to have peace. Born of God, people are the bride. The New Jerusalem is not a place, their name. They are described to the city New Jerusalem. That's what New Jerusalem is. It's not a place. It is dumb. It is a bride. It's called New Jerusalem. And people think that they're going to New Jerusalem. No, that's the bride. Bride's name is New Jerusalem. They will be with Jesus Christ in Mount Sion in heaven. And we all receive according to what we have done. Thank you for listening. God bless you and be with you all the time. Amen.